Hi, I'm Philip Santangelo. I'm a professor in the Department of Biomedical Engineering at Georgia Tech and Emory University. We make agents that allow us to detect molecules that you can't see. And so it actually specifically highlights those molecules, and many of the times it is related to RNA, which maybe is one of the nucleic acids that are important in the body, but it allows us to see where these molecules are. And in general, again, that's really, I would say, the focus of the lab is developing imaging tools to understand where these molecules are in the body or within cells. And so that's where the whole idea of spatial biology comes from, is where, how does the biology change and all, how is it altered in space, essentially. I was born in California, but I was raised on Long Island in New York. I am a scientist because I like solving problems. I get hooked on problems. So to me, science is about understanding what is, and the only way to find out what is to ask questions about what is and to answer those questions. To describe my lab, I would break it up into three parts. One of the parts is basically a conventional wet lab, where you have some instrumentation, but it's really set up for manipulating solutions and biological materials, but outside of a biosafety cabinet. So that's fairly conventional. And then we have two other areas. One is our cell culture room, which is really where I would say folks in my lab spend a lot of time, because we tend to work with cells and we tend to work with living cells. And a lot of our assays are related to cells while they're still alive. And so we do a lot of work within that culture room. In addition to that, we have an imaging space. So another room where we have a spinning disc confocal microscope, we have an additional wide field deconvolution microscope, and we also have the ability to culture cells there also, because we do there are additional live cell imaging experiments performed in that area. Probably the most critical thing about medical sciences is that it's infinite. You will always have really cool questions to go answer. You are not going to be bored. There is no question about it. It is impossible to be bored in this area, and it's incredibly fast-paced. It's changing all the time. And so I would say, compared to at least conventional engineering, which is a lot of fun and really interesting, biology opened so many doors to so many new questions that I just did not realize until I got into it that you could answer, and that there are all these new tools to develop and to use to answer those questions.